My name is Alyssa Michalke, and I have the unique privilege of serving as this year's Texas A&M Corps Cadets Commander. I am the first female to hold this position. The Corps Cadets here at Texas A&M is a four-year leadership development program in which we take high school students and turn them into high-quality leaders of character. It's a very regimented lifestyle, and it's one that you really get into routine, whereas, you know, other college students who aren't in the Corps may have a little bit more freedom to express themselves. Our cadets are held to a higher standard. Make your bed, shine your shoes, clean your room, iron your uniform. So the Corps is made up of only about 15% females. We still have some people with kind of the quote-unquote good old boy attitude. Being a female leader can be challenging at times, but we have a lot of really mature cadets who really see past that. I definitely placed a little bit more pressure on myself coming into this year, just knowing again that I kind of was now quote-unquote the face of these women who've come through the Corps 40 years ago. I didn't want to be the Corps commander who failed. I think it really sunk into me when I got a phone call the Monday that it was announced. I got a phone call and a Facebook message from a lady who was the first female on Corps staff, and she told me what it meant to her. Those women went through so much more than I ever did. Death threats, fellow Aggies trying to harm them or trying to tear their uniforms up. Them the stories you hear about, you know, make the hair on the back of your neck stand up. Formation is held every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday mornings at about 6 o'clock in the morning. My uniforms are supposed to be looking good or ready to go to do physical training. Even though I am the commander and I yell commands,
bring your units to parade rest!
I'm still held to the same standard that we hold our freshmen to. Every formation that we have, you'll see freshmen cadets running out of the dorms with their hands held high above their head and yelling A. Well, the sophomores usually are juniors leading them out to formation. During formation, we render honors to the colors, and then we march into chow as an entire corps. We all know that as cadets, we stick out. As female cadets, we stick out a little bit more. Being able to talk through some of the problems that we go through, you know, having to deal with guys who can do 40 pull-ups where we're over here doing maybe 10 or 15. You know, we're a little bit tougher on our fellow females because we want them to do well. We don't want them to, you know, to give the guys an excuse, so to say, to call us slower or not as worthy to wear a uniform. And I think some females get a little nervous. Maybe they get anxious about leading their peers, but I've found that as long as you know, you work hard, you respect your peers, and you show that you're willing to serve them, they're more than willing to follow you.